In March 2011, four, very possibly six nuclear reactors melted down in Fukushima, Japan, into the Pacific jet stream and the Pacific Ocean, imperiling and devastating the environment and the health of persons young and old, in a radioactive scourge that continues to this day and will continue for generations to come. Hi there, my name's Andrew. I've made for YouTube documentaries about the Fukushima disaster and the radiation plume that is moving across, from Fukushima into America, basically circling the northern hemisphere, causing mutations, cancers, early deaths, beyond which, beyond the worldwide nuclear plume that already exists from the thousands of nuclear tests that occurred from the 1940s into the 1980s. Now, the danger from Fukushima is ever-present. It's being ignored by the government, by our institutions. So what I've done now is I've set upon making a film, basically a docudrama or infotainment, to introduce the Fukushima disaster and the radioactive plume, plume gate, into the lexicon of the public consciousness by creating, yes, infotainment or a popcorn movie that tells the truth about Fukushima for a change. So I've basically thrown my hat over the fence, bitten off more than I can chew and chewed like crazy, and ended up with so far half a film. Now I'm asking for your help to financially back me. I have no financial backers, government support, to help me finish this film and have it distributed as widely as possible to film festivals and beyond. Now please consider donating to PayPal ebis73@gmail.com. Take a look at my documentaries to see who I am, where I've come from, and people who have collaborated with me in my documentaries and in this documentary film, documentary drama that we are making. It's entitled The Department. Yes, we're halfway through. It's a conversation that people need to hear about radiation, because all they're hearing otherwise is mindless pop culture and endless sports events, which I'm sure you're familiar with, but aren't always as essential as the news stations seem to think they are. So we need a conversation that is being ignored by government, green groups. It's a conversation about Fukushima, about radiation, about spent nuclear fuel storage that threatens an even greater disaster than Fukushima, many times over, if that were unimaginable. But definitely on the cards. So if you care about Fukushima, about your children's future, spread the word about Fukushima, provide links to people, support activists, and please consider giving some financial backing to this film, because I've spent thousands of dollars of my own funds in making this film, and I've committed myself to finishing it at some stage, and activism is film activism is made possible through crowdfunding, and please, if you could, have a look at this trailer and share it as widely as possible, and I look forward to hearing some of your feedback about the trailer. And I hope to release the film as soon as possible. Thank you very much for your attention and your support.
How bad is it?
It's very bad.
Worse than Chernobyl would be an understatement. We will have to get moving fast on moderating the news coverage of the accident. Who will you have in mind for directing the cover-up?
We need the latest on Daiichi. The real deal now. Not the BS you're dealing to the public, yeah?
The truth is hard to say right now.
Well, what can you extrapolate from what you do know? We know it is worse than 1986.
There are 6 reactor buildings. Each with nuclear reactor cores, with 100 tons of nuclear fuel rods. One, two, and 3 melted down. These 3 reactor cores are probably melting into the ground below.
That's going to be very difficult to conceal.
We create a series of bluffs, diversions, and contrary signals to obscure what is actually going on in Fukushima.
Why do you think the government hides it?
The nuclear industry is the government. Some people protest, but too many just go along. If they can't see the radiation, for them, it does not exist. As long as we are here, Emiko will be fine. Kids who live near Fukushima area, they are, underweight, fatigue, even heart attacks suddenly. I want to thank you for reporting on this. There's media silence in Japan, but I think maybe it's better here in America.